I need to get a picture. Do you guys want to sit on and just let me get a picture?
Sure.
Man.
They said Delta flying with the jumbo jets.
Where?
Yeah.
Brian says Atlanta Honolulu in the morning. With Atlanta Paris by Athens.
Paris.
Did you read that about
New York, Tel Aviv?
Yeah.
It's Atlanta, New York, John F. Kennedy, probably.
Probably Atlanta, Honolulu, Tokyo. What did they do? Tokyo,
Hong Kong.
Something, but then they have like a Seoul, Detroit, New York. Very complicated.
I mean, yeah, very.
Yeah.
They have very issues.
Yeah.
No.
Delta.
Look at the Titanic. And change. Go to the.
Exactly.
They're gonna come up with a new design in a couple years, right?
Yeah. That's, we're gonna have a new one here pretty soon.
I was like, oh, we're getting your paddles.
Yeah, we can get that one. Yeah, back when they served with China and.
Oh, yeah, back in.
The glory days.
That was the bygone days. I used to have the tape up here running when this flew for the last time.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
See, so don't choke the wind.
And maybe somebody told me because the chief in the time was
that the iconic symbol known today as the widget was introduced. Over the next few decades, our logo changed many times. It's not by coincidence that the inside of the triangle looks like the wings and tail of a plane flying overhead. In fact, each element has a special significance. The triangle points to the sky where we fly. It's the pinnacle of professional achievement. The white V is the slick wing of a jet, while the flat base is the solid foundation of Delta Airlines. Red for the flame of leadership that drives it upward. The official widget was first introduced alongside Delta's Royal Jet Service that offered passengers luxurious travel on our DC-8s, Convair 880s, and EC-9s. The Delta widget became the icon for air and marked all of the operation.
I Break the allergy, that'll please.